Welcome to our educational channel. In this video from the quantitative aptitude. So in this quantitative aptitude, let us see the chapter simple interest. So we'll see some important or shortcut tricks from the simple interest topic and how to calculate the examination point of view questions. Let us see one by one. First, when you see what is the meaning of this interest. So this is the money which is paid by extra. Just I wrote the definition here. If any person borrowed some money from the other for a fixed period, then he has to pay some extra money to him for the use of money lent. This extra money paid for the use of it, using this other's money, is called interest. Okay, actually in the come to the simple interest, for example, rupees 6 per annum. Per annum means for every 100 rupees. Okay, just let me write the full word. When you see the problems, you can see this word. So rupees x or rupees 6, rupees 12, anything, rupees 6 per annum. So annum is just for 1 year. So if you see this word, for 1 year, if you give in the, if you deposit some money in the bank or for others, so after 1 year, for every 100 rupees, they'll give 6 rupees extra. That means per 100. That's why simple interest will come under. So per every 100. So that's why the simple interest formula, P is the principal amount which you are taking from the bank or from other person, and T is the time. The time period must be in year, years compulsory this is, and R is the rate of interest and divide by 100. That's why simple interest is PTR by 100. For every 100 only we should calculate per 1 year, for every year. That's why time period must be in years and P is, R is the rate of interest. So is the rate of interest, if it is 8% means 8 out of 100. For every 100 rupees, 8 rupees the extra they must pay along with this 100. So that is the interest. So that's why PTR by 100 is the simple interest. And P is the principal, T is the time. If it is 6 years, T is the 6 we can keep. And time is for 3 years, 3 we can keep. And in case the 3.5, 4.5, if it is years and months combined, then also you have to convert into the years only. If it is only 6 months, so 6 months if it is the time, then you can calculate into years is 6 divided by 12, so 1 by 2 year. So in the place of T, we'll write 1 by 2. Okay, that is one thing. And one more, if the date is according to the, within the given period, for example, 20th April, and person took 20th April to same 20th September. So they took the money on 20th April and give it back 20th September. So in this, so which is, on which date he took the amount, that will not be counted. So this is not counted, but which he deposited, that date is only counted. So 20th April is not counted. This comes from the 21st April onwards. Okay, on which day, which date, particular date, on which day you took the amount from the bank or from other person, that will not count it. So 21st April to even 20th. Which date we deposited, which we withdraw, that date also be counted. But which date we are giving, that is not counted. So 21st April to 20th September will count. We'll count all the days and we'll divide with 365. Then to convert into years. So for example, X days. The days divided by 365. Then we'll come under in terms of years. Okay, the months to the years is divided by 12. Days to the years is 365. So even if it is leap year or anything also, same 365 only you can take. Okay, that you can remember. These are the basic things. Actually, how the problems will be in the simple interest and how to apply this formula. Simple interest is PTR by 100, right? And similarly, amount is equals to P plus interest or simple interest. Amount is the total amount, how much you have to get. That is along with the principal. Principal amount is which you are giving. Okay, for example, 100 rupees you gave. After 1 year, if it is 8% interest, they will get extra 8. So 100 plus 8 is 180 is the amount after 1 year. Principal we deposit only 100 rupees, but after 1 year we got 108. That's why principal plus interest or simple interest. That is called amount. Okay, these are the basic formulas we will apply in the problems. And let us see how the numerical sums will come and what are the shortcut tricks. If any huge big word problems also, shortcut tricks, let us see one by one. Let us see the problems here. A sum of money doubles itself in 20 years. In how many years? will it become four times? Okay, sum of the money. So let the principal be x. So to make you understand clearly, let me take the step by step. Let the principal amount, let be x you take. Actually, the main three formulas you must remember. So simple interest, just you can take interest on it. Simple interest or interest. When you come to the next topic is compound interest, we'll use the CI. Now simple interest is SI. I'm writing as I only in this topic. So simple interest or interest, that is equals to PTR by 100. This is one. And amount is equals to P plus I. Okay, principal amount plus interest, that is the total amount. The sum, how much you deposited plus interest, there is nothing but amount. If you write this, P plus I is nothing but again PTR by 100. Okay, these all same formulas, or else you can take the P common, 1 plus TR by 100. So according to requirement, you can apply in this among these three. So this 1, 2, 3 all same only. But as per the requirement, you can take. The main thing is interest is PTR by 100, right? Now we come to the problem. Sum of money double itself in 20 years. So principal is X. Double means 2X. Okay, it becomes 2X. So 2x, how many after 20 years? So principal amount is x only. X plus, okay, the second formula apply. A is equal to P plus PTR by 100. Because we don't know I value. A is equal to P plus PTR by 100. So A is equals to double. Because sum of the money double itself in 20 years. So it becomes 2x. So x if we deposited, we get 2x. So A is equal to 2x. And our principal is x only. Plus PTR by 100. So x same t, time is 20 years, and r by 100. Okay, this is 1, right? Let me equation 1. And in how many years will it become 4 times? 4 times means let it be 4x. According to the next one, in how many years it will become 4 times? This is 1. 2x is equal to x plus x into 20 into r by 100. You don't even rate of interest, just apply. But in how many years it will become 4 times? So 4x. X if you deposit, you get the 4x. So x plus, same we can take. So x into, here is a time we don't know. So let it be t itself. And r as it is, divide by 100. Okay, let it be equation 2. Right, now we can apply. This is the 4x is equal to x plus this. Let me take the first equation. From the first equation, take x common. From the first equation, if you take x common, 2x is this side. And this side is, if you take x common, how much you get? 1 plus r into 20, or 20r by 100, right? And cancel this. We can cancel this x and x, then 2 is equals to, 2 is equals to same, 1 plus 20r by 100. You can do LCM, 100 plus 20r by 100. Using this, we'll find out the rate of interest first. If you know rate of interest, you can substitute here. Okay, from this, you can calculate more. Now, what you can calculate, 100, you can take this side, 200 LHS. And this 100, take again LHS minus 100 is equals to 20R. Then 100 is equals to 20R. From this, R is equals to 5, because 25 is 100. So rate of interest is 5%. Now 5%, you can substitute in equation 2, we'll get the T. Okay, see here. Same. Similarly, here also, from the equation 2 also take, from equation 2 now, 4x is equal to, take x common. So 1 plus tr, okay, small r, tr by 100. In this same, as usual, x is a common, cancel. And 4 is equals to 1 plus t, we should find out, r is 5. Okay, t into 5 by 100. Now, from this, we can simplify now. That is, how much you get? 100 plus 5t by, all divided by 100. that is equals to 4. Then 400 is equals to 100 plus 5 into t. 5 into t is equal to 300. Take other side. Then t is equals to 60 because 300 by 5. So 60 years. Okay, this is the time. In 60 years, according to that, for the 20 years, in 60 years it will become 4 times. Okay, the 20 years if it is double means money should be double itself in 20 years. In how many years it will become 4 times is 60 years, you can see here. And for this one simple shortcut trick I'll show, if you all just you can see. The short method is, in case of a particular years it will become double and how many years will become 4 times or 5 times. Such type of things, you remember this. So n minus 1 into t by m minus 1. This is the required time. Required time is equals to. So n minus 1. N is 4 minus 1. So because how many years it becomes a question if they ask you. N is the given asked. M is which is given. So 4 minus 1 and 2 minus 1. Because n is the for 4 years how much it becomes. In 2 years already it's double now. Is given. So 4 minus 1 into 2 minus 1 and t is for 20 years is given already. Just a short type. So n minus 1 into t and m minus 1 into t, same as this ratio. Yes, you can simplify this. 3 into 20 by 1, yeah, 60. 60 years. That means just a short type. T1, T2, if you observe, crossway. This divided by this ratio will be same. This trick you can remember. So in this case, the how many years question, number of times question is on top, which is given and down. That is, m is given, n we have to find out for n years, for 4 years. So how many years it will become 4 times. This is 4 times. This is 2 times. So 4 minus 1 into t by 2 minus 1, 60 years. If you can remember this, or just you can normal method. This is a procedure you can follow. Okay, for every type of questions, there is some shortcut tricks. Let us see the few more sums. Let us see one more question similar like previous, but it is here. What is the rate of simple interest? R value should find out at which the sum of money doubles itself in 5 years. The sum of the money will be double itself in 5 years. So let rupees P doubles in 5 years at the rate of simple interest is R percent per annum. Let it be. So we know already PTR by 100 is the simple interest formula. Okay, so therefore what you can write, P into 2. Actually principal is P, but double means P into 2. So amount is equals to, because the formula you don't forget. So A is equals to P plus, and again PTR by 100. Okay, this we discussed previous. A is equals to principal plus interest. Interest formula is PTR by 100. So A is doubles itself. So P into 2. That means A value. And again P plus, same as usual. P into R into time is 5 years. PTR or PRT. Okay. By 100. From this we can find out the R value, simple. Okay. That is one way. If you take the P common. So this is P into 2. If you take the P is a common. 1 plus R into 5. So 5R by 100. Just cancel this P both the sides, and 2 is equals to 1 plus 5R by 100. So 100 plus 5R by 100. Simplify this. 200 is equals to 100. Take this side. 2 into 100 is 200. 100 plus 5R. Then 5R is equals to 200 minus 100 is 100. Then R is equals to 20. Okay, 20%. This is the rate of interest. And same problem, I'll write one required rate, one simple shortcut technique here. So required rate, the short method, if you observe, because even you can do in this way, but still if you want to do very fast, just you can see this. The required rate is equals to, so n minus 1 into 100 by t. Here is n is number of times. So n is the number of times. How many times doubles? Doubles it is. Doubles means two times. The principal should becomes two times or three times. That is the n. N is equals to. So according to the question, this doubles means n is equals to 2. So minus 1 into 100 as usual. And t is the time period. Within how many period term it should be double? 5 years. So divide by 5. Okay, just you can remember this. 2 minus 1 is 1 into 100 by 5. 100 by 5 is 20. So 20% is the required rate. N minus 1 into 100 by t. N is number of times. Doubles, no? So in 2 it is. If it is thrice means 3 will write. And t is the time period, 5 years. So 20%. So for all the problems, you will see some shortcut trick also. For this type of questions, you can apply in this way. Okay, let us see other more. So this problem, A deposits, a person deposits a sum of money in a bank who pays 10% simple interest. So this is the R, rate of interest. At the end of 5 years, so it's a T. T is equal to 5 years. He receives 30,000. So this is the amount. Okay, then what sum he had deposited in the bank? So A is given. So according to the formula, normal formula is A is equals to P plus interest. So interest is not given separately. So you can write again PTR by 100. Okay, A is equals to P plus PTR by 100. So in this formula, you apply values directly to get the answer. So A is 30,000. Okay, that you can take. And P only we should find out. So P into P TR. Time is 5, R is 10. Okay, 5 into 10 by 100 as usual. Yes, from this you can calculate the P value easy. Okay, you can calculate this. 0, 0 you can cut and 5 ones are 5, 2s are. So P plus P by 2 this is. If you do LCM, okay, 2P plus 1. So 3P by 2 it is. That is 30,000. From this you can calculate the P directly. So principal amount is equal to 30,000 into 3 by 2 is reciprocal 2 by 3. Once cancel this one, 4 zeros. So 10,000 into 2 is 20,000. So that is 20,000 is it. Find out the P value. This is normal direct formula. Once you can observe one shortcut way. So required sum that P is equals to, so 100A by 100 plus R into T. Same from this formula only, this is a took. Just you can take the P common and take other side. You can apply in this to find out the P value directly. If you know amount and rate of interest and time, to find out the P value is this. No problem, you can substitute values. A is 30,000, R and T 50. Then you can get the answer as usual. So 100 into amount is 30,000 divided by 100 plus R into T. 5 into 10, 50. Okay, 100 plus 50 is 150, right? 150. You can calculate this. 150, 1 0, 150, 2 0, 300, more 2 zeros. 200, sir. 200 into 100 is the same, 20,000. Yes, this also the shortcut trick. Can remember this or this? In this, you have to do extra one more calculation, taking the P, LCM, and do. You remember this to find out. Same, both the formulas are same. Is the subject is A, it is the subject is P. So all the P terms only took LHS and took the P common. In this way, same it is as usual, you can apply. With some more tricks, let us see a few more problems. We'll see one question in the combination with the interest and principal in this way. Question is, a man lent a sum of money at the rate of simple interest, 4%. Okay, this is the R, right? I'm writing the interest for 8 years. So time is 8 years is 340 less than the principal. So interest is 340 less than the principal. That means principal minus interest is 340. Okay, principal is more, interest is only 340 less. That's why principal minus interest is equal to 340 from the given statement according to this. Okay, so because at the rate of same 4% rate 8 years, that interest is 340 less than the principal. This is the main line. Let us have the formulas. So P minus interest formula is again PTR by 100, right? That is equal to 340. Because we need to find out the P value only. What was the principal is the question. So let us take the P common. Okay, if you take the P common, 1 minus TR by 100 is equal to 340. P is the common. So 1 minus TR by 100. Yes, P, let it be asked, is 1 minus TR. T is 8 and R is 4. So directly multiply. 8 into 4 by 100 is equal to 340. You calculate now. So P into 8 into 4, 32. So 100 minus 32 by 100. LCM I did is equal to 340. Just you can calculate then from this. Let me continue this side. P within the bracket 100 minus 32 by 100 now. So this you can take. How much you get? 68 by 100 is equal to 340. So P value we required just is 340 into 100 by 68. You can calculate this. 68 ones are 68, 5 times it is. Any table you can cancel. Once 5. 5 into 100 is 500. So the rupees 500 is the principal amount. This is the main thing, because anything, the condition is this: principal minus interest is equal to 340, because that is 340 less than the principal asset. Okay, this only the direct way you can use shortcut. One more shortcut is there, but it's not necessary. This type only you can do such type of questions. So in this problem, a sum was put at simple interest at a certain rate for 3 years. Okay, certain rate. So the required rate, original rate is R%, and let the sum be P, let be principal, and original rate it be R% for 3 years. But in case had it been put 4% higher rate of interest, 4% higher if you keep, it would have fetched 120 rupees more. So interest will get more it is. So with the R as rate of interest for 3 years, one interest will get, and R plus 4 because 4% higher rate, then we'll get extra 120 rupees. That means difference between the two simple interest is 120. That's why you can make like this. So interest is equals to PTR by 100. Okay, this is the original formula. Now difference between two different interest. So the which is increasing, R plus 4. That means from the given line you can write PTR by 100, right? So P, time is 3 years and rate is R plus 4. Originally is R, but extra 4 by 100. From this, the previous one you can subtract. That is how much? P into same, time is 3, but R by 100. The difference is 120 extra. Okay, understood this stuff. Some simple interest only, rate for 3 years, but it had been 4% higher rate. So original rate is R, higher is R plus 4. The difference between simple interest is 120, because it fetched 120 rupees more. This, if you can calculate, you'll get the P value. That is one way. Okay, let me do this, and I'll write the shortcut trick also for this type of questions. Let's have an idea about this. Okay, if you can separate the this all into, so P into 3 R plus 4. So P into 3 is 3P. 3P R by 100 plus again 3P 4. 3P 4 by 100 we can take separately, right? P3R, this is the R plus 4, R is once and 4 is once, you separate the denominator, minus same P3R or same 3PR by 100 is equal to 120, right? You can cancel this, this full set is same as this, you can cancel. So 3 into P into 4 by 100, 3 4 is 12, 12P by 100 is equals to 120. Okay, from this P is equals to 120 into 100 by 12. Cancel this. 12 tens of 120 into 100 is 1000. So P is equal to 1000. This is the way. Or the required sum, if you want to the short method. Okay, this is the original according to the statement. And if you go through the short method, the required sum is equal to 100 into difference by R into T. Same, 100 into difference by R into T. 100 into difference is 120 by R into T. R is, so here is increasing. So how much it is 4. Okay, R means increasing, how much is increased, the increasing rate. 4 and time is 3. Yes, you can calculate. R is nothing but the increased, how much is increased, that only should calculate. Okay, into 3. You can calculate this, is also you get same 1000. Okay, 4, 3 is a 12, 10, 1000. Okay, that is equals to P. In this case, D is the difference, how much difference is more difference, and this more rate. That only should calculate here to do this. Okay, the main basic concept, if you can remember and solve this in this way, or else you can remember the short trick also, such type of questions. Let's see a few more in case the more difference methods now. So in this problem, at certain rate of simple interest, rupees 800 amounted to 920. That means this is the P and it is A, okay, in 3 years. So it's a time. So P is equals to 800 and amount is 920, time is 3 years. If the rate of interest be increased by 3%, what will be the amount after 3 years? The rate of interest be increased by 3%. But according to this data, we'll find out rate of interest first. Okay, there is only the method, easy way. So we know that A is equals to P plus interest, we don't know. So again, interest formula is PTR by 100. So amount is equal to principal plus interest formula. We'll substitute in this to get the R value first. Amount is 800. Sorry, amount is 920. 920 and principal is 800 as usual is given. No? So again, P is 800 into time is 3 years. R we should find out. So it is the rate of interest by 100. Now using this, we can calculate the R value first. We can cancel this, 100 ones, 108, okay. 800 take LHS, 920 minus 800, that is 8 into 3, 24 into R. 920 minus 800 is 120, 24 take this side, divide by 24 is equals to R. So okay, calculate this, 24 ones, 24 5. So R is equals to 5%. So rate of interest is 5% now, right? Now, what according to the problem, what is next? The rate of interest be increased by 3%. If the rate of interest is increased by 3%, so new rate. So new rate is equals to, the old rate is 5%. 5 plus increased by 3. So total 8% is rate of interest now. Now we can calculate the interest value, PTR by 100. What will be the amount after 3 years they asked. So if you can calculate interest, we can add to the principal to get the amount. Now interest is same, PTR by 100. Principal is 800. Time 3 years. And rate of interest is 8 by 100. Okay, same, in case it is increased by 3%, what will be the amount they asked. So generally this is the way, but if it increase, this in this condition. So 100 ones are 108. 8 into 3 into 8 is a 24 into 8. So it's 192. There is interest. Right? Now we can calculate the required amount. So amount is equal to same. 800 plus this 192. So 992 is the amount. Okay, this is in general condition, you should find out rate of interest first. Then you can apply same after 3 years, if it is increased by 3%, then amount becomes 992. Originally is 920, if the interest is increased by 3% means it becomes 992. Okay, there is a change to say this. Okay, shortcut trick almost is some big type similarly. Let us see another question, one more last. Let's have one more question, the last one. In this dividing type, a sum of rupees 810 is divided into two parts such that okay, one part is 4% for 3 years is equal to second part of 85% for 3 years. So in this case, let the first part of the sum be x, because two parts now total is 810. So let the first part, total two parts, let be first part of the sum. Let first part of the sum be rupees x you take. If it is x and second part we can find out easily now. That is from the total. Second part becomes total is 810. So from 810 minus x is the second part. Okay, now we'll find out the first part and second part separately interest. Both interest are same. Okay, so interest on this part and this part is must be same according to the question. So that simple interest is PTR by 100. So first part principal is x. As I mentioned, 4% rate for 3 years is equal to second part rate 5% for 3 years. Time is same for both, but rate of interest is different. So PTR by 100. So P is x. Time is 3 years. R is 4% by 100. This value is exactly equals to one more. Principal is 810 minus x. This is the principal. Again, time 3 years. Rate of interest is 5 by 100. Okay, this is the equal. This is a simple question. The main thing, this is the from a given. Okay, from given is this is, because both the interest are same, first part and second part. Same PTR by 100. Now, cancelling you can do easily. Divide by 100, divide by 100. No, you can cancel this. There is a 3 LHS and 3 RHS because multiplication symbols either side, so you can cancel. Now 4 into x, so this is a 4x, 810 minus x into 5. Okay, you can multiply this 5 into 810 minus 5 into x, 5 into 810 minus 5 into x. Take the x terms one side. Okay, minus x take this side plus 5x. 4x plus 5x is equals to 810 into 5 is 4050. Okay, 4x plus 5x is 9x. 9x is equal to 4050. From this we can write the x value. Okay, let me do this side. Then x is equals to, yeah, from this you can write the x value, because already 9x is equals to 4050, and from this x is equals to 4050 divided by 9. Yeah, that is 450. 9 4 0 36 yeah 450. X is equals to 450. Then this is the first part, because x, and second part is 810 minus x, right? 810 minus 450, 360. This is simple. So the total two parts they asked, one part is 450, one part is 360. You can add again, you'll get 810 on. So okay, this is the way we can solve. I gave few problems, shortcut tricks also. So you can practice similar questions, and some more type is available in our channel. You can go through if you require. Well, basically most of the type of questions from simple interest, you can get the problems like this. And similarly problems you can go through in our channel only. Some more problems based on the quantity aptitude available in our channel, you can go through it.